In this video, I'm going to share four different ways of moving abroad to countries like USA and European countries to build a career in data science or software engineering. Tip number one is to work in a multinational company in your home country, which has a headquarter or the office in these countries that you want to move to. For example, in India, there are many offices that these product based or even other companies have which are based in US. So Amazon, Google, Facebook, all these big companies have offices in India. So one way is you get a job in the local office, which is in India, Bangalore or Hyderabad, wherever. I know cracking interviews of product based companies is difficult, but you have to do hard work. You know, you don't get an opportunity to come to foreign countries without doing that much hard work. So once you get a job there, you work there for some time, you prove yourself, you build connections, and then you can apply for inter-office transfer. I used to work for Nvidia 13 years back, and that was in Pune, India. And I know many people from Pune, India office took inter-office transfer to California, USA office. Now, everyone wants to move to a foreign country, most of the people at least. So it's not possible for the company to allow everyone to do inter-office transfer. So it's a matter of luck as well as your hard work and what kind of networking you are doing. See, inter-office social networking is very, very important. You need to build a good rapport with the people or the managers who are working for a foreign location, and that way you can apply for inter-office transfer and you have a higher chances of success. Till date, majority of the product-based companies, they are either in US and Europe. So when you come here and work in foreign countries, you get a good exposure. You get to earn a lot of money as well. So there are a lot of benefits of moving abroad. So working for MNC and taking inter-office transfer is number one way. And this way is very kind of safe and secure, you know. Number two is you work for IT service-based companies such as Infosys, Cognizant, and then you work for clients which are located in these countries such as US and European countries. And while you're working for these clients, you might get an opportunity to visit the client offices for a short-term duration, maybe month or maybe 6 months. During that time period, again, you build a good connection, good real rapport with the people here. Now, if you are, let's say, if Infosys is doing a project for Pfizer will not hire you because they have an agreement with Infosys that they cannot hire Infosys resources. But while you are here, you can explore, you can build connection, you can apply in different companies here. Because once you are physically here on, let's say, H1, L1, whatever visa, it becomes very easy for you to apply in different companies and then get a job. And once you get a job, you can get your H1 transferred. And that way, I have been living in US for 13 years now. And I know so many people, hundreds of people who have done this. They come through service-based company here and they find a permanent job here. And then they end up staying here for a long time period. Third way is studies. You can come to US for masters, and after masters you can get 3-year OPT, during which you don't have to worry about H1. You know, many people say, oh, right now COVID is going and will we get H1? Like, don't think about all of that, because 3 years you get an OPT. All you have to do is get a job, and you can, more majority of the people end up getting their H1. You know, it takes effort, but you will be all right. I made a different video on just this topic on masters. So link is in video description below. Check it out. So coming for masters in US or even other countries such as Germany, Bharat in Germany is a nice YouTube channel which talks about if you want to migrate to Germany either for studies or work, what are the steps you need to take. Germany has a free education. So how you can utilize that, how you can build that career. All that information is in that channel. The channel name is Bharat in Germany. Video description below contains the link. The fourth way is immigration. So let's say For example, you want to move to Canada, okay? So Canada has an immigration program called PNP, Province Nominee Program. Canada, the northern region, has a lot of states where there is not much population. So Canadian government started this PNP program so that people can stay there and there is economic development. So I know many people who have come here in Canada on PNP program. So that is definitely a good option. Similarly, Australia, New Zealand, different countries have different type of immigration programs. You need to check it with local visa consultant. The other little different way of coming to, let's say, US is getting married to a person. I'm from Gujarat state in India, and I have seen many people who get married to a foreign national, let's say US citizen, and they come here. Now that is very easy, like you may get married to US citizen, you come here, you get your green card immediately. But in order to build a career, of course, you should not compromise on your social front. So make sure you take that decision in an informed way. In the video description below, I have given information on PNP program, which is Canada immigration program. It takes around 18 months to come here. So there is a link in the video description below. Check it out. There is another link where a person has mentioned his experience on how he came to Canada and build a career in data science. So check that link as well. And I hope you find this video useful. There used to be fifth way, which is there are some consulting companies in US who used to file H1 directly. So from India, you can come to US directly, but that way is kind of not working right now. There are still few companies and few people get lucky. So if you have any contacts of consulting companies in US, you can even try that. You know, probability of making that successful is low, but still there are a few people who come through that way. So try out all these options. Foreign countries, when you come here, you get an opportunity to earn a lot of money, to get exposure working in a different environment, working for big product-based companies. So there are many benefits of moving abroad for the job. But of course, along with the benefits, there are downsides as well. So you need to be mindful about that. You need to be mindful about the social consequences. You know, let's say you are the only child of your parents, and if you come here, it kind of becomes tricky. You know, there is a social challenge associated with it. So consider all that factors and make an informed decision. I hope you like this video. If you do, give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends who want to build a career in data science or software engineering in foreign countries.